wonderful world of Disney. This week, from Walt Disney's wonderful world of color, Disneyland around the seasons. And now your host, Walt Disney.
This is not Santa's workshop. It's just one section of a creative world where new attractions for Disneyland are conceived. Now, a great deal of time, sweat, and a few tears were expended on all this, but there's a lot of satisfaction in developing ideas into realities which become a part of Disneyland. Now, we've just finished the first year of our second decade. It was a big year for the opening of many new attractions. Since they were opened, 7 million people have enjoyed them. So we'd like for you to see and enjoy them too. But first, let's turn back the calendar to the beginning of Disneyland's second decade. It all began when the new year started off with a... Ushering in the new year anywhere is always gay and exciting. But this festive spirit continues throughout the year at Disneyland, where every day is a holiday. Since the Magic Kingdom was first opened 11 years ago, 60 million people from all over the world have come here. And each year, there's always something new for them to enjoy. Here in Adventureland, there's a welcoming committee around every bend in the river. Second decade is appropriately inaugurated as a jet-propelled man blasts off from Tomorrowland. Ever since man has watched birds in flight, he has had a desire to fly like this. The name of our latest attraction at Disneyland. Its stars are the children of the world. Every land from A to Z, from Asia to Zululand, is represented. From sketches and finished drawings, these scale models were constructed. Then, by our electronic process, which we call audio animatronics, they were given voice and movement. Now, this is a scale model of a 30-foot-high clock at the Small World entrance. It's the most unique musical timepiece ever created. At each quarter hour, when its cogs, gears, and springs and wheels are set into motion, the clock actually performs the time. Quieter ways to find out the correct time, but they're not as much fun. And now let's turn the clock back to the opening day ceremonies of It's a Small World. Children and old world folk dancers in their native costumes participated in the parade. The dedication ceremonies were attended by consular officials, representatives of the press, and thousands of Disneyland visitors. But the very special guests were children from many nations. Flown to Disneyland from the major oceans and seas was added to the Small World's seven seaways. Bon voyage to the happiest cruise that ever sailed round the world. Outward bound passengers enjoy a close view of these fanciful figures, which are shaped from growing trees and shrubs. Here we enter the children's world of imagination, fun, and laughter as we start our globe-circling tour in the Scandinavian countries. During our voyage, we'll visit more than 100 lands. Let's see how many we can identify. Toy soldiers guard Copenhagen's Tivoli Garden. We drop in on the Emerald Isle, land of shamrocks and leprechauns. A wee bagpiper welcomes us to Scotland. and jolly old England.
It's a small world after all. It's a small, small world.
The Wooden Shoe Children of Holland. This could only be Gay Paris. Next, we pass through the Balkans and Greece into exotic Asia. Fabulous Taj Mahal and flying carpets that glide beneath a veiled sun. The beautiful children of Southeast Asia. As we enter the mysterious dark continent of Africa, we are greeted by Cleopatra. One thing in common, a love of laughter. It's the rainy season in the rainforests of Brazil. Invited to a carnival in Rio. And now we say saludos amigos to our good neighbor, Mexico. Grand finale, all children of the world join in to sing It's a Small World After All. Small World cruise is longer and there's much more to see, but we must move on to our other new attraction. Ever since I was a youngster, I've had a great personal admiration for Abraham Lincoln. So when we decided to bring to Disneyland's visitors some great moments in Mr. Lincoln's life, we began an exhaustive research. We studied his mannerisms, his gestures, and even his voice characteristics. Above all, we wanted to create a faithful physical likeness in this audio animatronic figure of Mr. Lincoln. When we held the opening ceremonies, it was a great occasion for all of us. Now let's go into the Opera House and listen carefully to the words of Mr. Lincoln, spoken by him a century ago, but which still apply today to free men everywhere.
The world has never had a good definition of the word liberty. The American people just now are much in want of one. We all declare for liberty. But in using the same word, we do not all mean the same thing. What constitutes the bulwark of our liberty and independence? It is not our frowning battlements, our bristling sea coasts. These are not our reliance against tyranny. Our reliance is in the love of liberty, which God has planted in our bosom. Our defense is in the preservation of the spirit which prizes liberty as the heritage of all men, in all lands, everywhere. Destroy this spirit, and you have planted the seeds of despotism around your own doors. At what point shall we expect the approach of danger? By what means shall we fortify against it? Shall we expect some transatlantic military giant to step the ocean and crush us at a blow? Never. All the armies of Europe, Asia, and Africa combined could not by force take a drink from the Ohio, or make a track on the Blue Ridge in a trial of 1,000 years. At what point, then, is the approach of danger to be expected? I answer that if it ever reaches, it must spring from amongst us. It cannot come from abroad. As a nation of free men, we must live through all time or die by suicide. Let reverence for the law be breathed by every American mother to the lisping babe that prattles on her lap. Let it be taught in the schools, in the seminaries, and in the colleges. Let it be written in primers, in spelling books and almanacs. And in short, let it become the political religion of the nation. And let the old and the young the rich and the poor, the grave and the gay, of all sexes and tongues and colors and conditions, sacrifice unceasingly at its altar. And let us strive to deserve, as far as mortals may, the continued care of divine providence, trusting that in future national emergencies, he will not fail to provide us the instruments of safety and security. Let us have faith that right makes might. And in that faith, let us to the end dare to do our duty as we understand it.
Disneyland has always had a big river and a Mississippi sternwheeler. It seemed appropriate to create a new attraction at the bend of the river. And so Disneyland's New Orleans Square came into being. A New Orleans of a century ago when she was the gay Paris of the American frontier. In 1803, the United States wanted New Orleans for a port. In order to get it, we had to make a package deal with Napoleon. He insisted that we buy the peripheral area. So we threw in an extra million and ended up with 800,000 square miles. The Louisiana Purchase was probably the greatest real estate deal of all time. It included all of this territory from the Gulf to Canada. Total cost, $11 million. And by the way, Disneyland's New Orleans Square alone cost $15 million. But of course, a dollar went much further in those days. It was a gala day when we officially opened New Orleans Square. We had a real jubilee, Southern style. Aboard the Mark Twain, representatives of the press and other guests got a preview of New Orleans Square as they came downriver for the opening ceremonies. Architecture and atmosphere of old New Orleans of the 1850s has been retained. The narrow winding streets, intimate courtyards, and the iron-laced balconies are authentic in every detail. Our special guest was the mayor of the first New Orleans, Louisiana, that is. After the usual dedication speeches, we presented his honor with the key to Disneyland's New Orleans. Tradition of old New Orleans, add color to the streets and courtyards. The quaint shops offer treasures from all over the world. Craftsmen create articles in silver, stained glass, and many other materials. Thank you. Orleans was the birthplace of marching jazz bands. Here in Disneyland's New Orleans Square, this tradition is an everyday occurrence. Diners in French and Creole sidewalk cafes are entertained in true Dixieland fashion. A small section of Disneyland's new adventure, the Primeval World. When we started to recreate the huge animals that roamed the Earth 200 million years ago, we started with these one-inch scale figures. Then we worked our way straight up to their actual sizes. Some are 22 feet tall. You know, nature wasn't creating household pets in that era. Now, to give realism and life to these prehistoric giants, we applied the art of animatronics, which give them three-dimensional animation. So now let's go back 200 million years to the Primeval World. It's just a short trip on the Disneyland Santa Fe Railroad. Disneyland, we do our Christmas planning early, looking forward to it like a lot of happy kids. These are some of the models for our Christmas Fantasy on Parade. We prepare for this event as we do for all of our other attractions. Every Christmas season, thousands of children and their families line the curbs of Disneyland's Main Street making it the happiest street in the world. So let's go there now and join the crowds for Fantasy on Parade.
Is about to start at Disneyland's Storybook Castle. Gets into the act. And here's the most popular teddy bear of them all, Winnie the Pooh, with his favorite honey tree. Her Royal Highness, the Queen Bee. Also, from the famous Pooh stories, is Kanga. It's Roo, Kanga's bouncy youngster. Classic Arabian Nights stories, a very talented camel, and harem dancing girl. Captain Hook's pirate ship.
Here they come, Mr. Smee! Fire, Mr. Smee! Shoot him down!
Aye, 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 Captain!
On this king-size bed are Peter Pan, Michael, John, and Wendy. Walt Disney's animated cartoon, Dumbo, are these pink circus elephants on parade. Christmas spirit.
Pluto puts on a dog show, he goes all out. A dog leading a dog. Disney's Academy Award-winning motion picture, here's Mary Poppins and the London Chimney Sweeps doing their routine, Step in Time. It's Alice from Wonderland and the White Rabbit. And the Mad Hatter. Fantasia Follies with the Ostrich Ballet from Dance of the Hours. And those two-ton ballerinas, the Hefty Hippos. Come right off the farm with an old-fashioned country hoedown. Soldier. There they are, the most famous of all reindeer. Dancer and Prancer, Donner and Blitzen, Comet, Cupid and Vixen. Candidate for the most popular person in the world, Santa Claus. And as always, Santa is loaded with gifts for the youngster. Of toy balloons from the toy train signals the final curtain to Fantasy on Parade. And the beginning of the nighttime Christmas festivities.
The candlelight procession now approaching down Disneyland's Main Street is composed of church and school choirs from all over Southern California. In just a few moments, the choirs will gather in front of the railway station at the town square. Western High School a cappella choir.
Has been a big one for us. It gave us a good start into Disneyland's second decade. But even now, we're thinking ahead and creating new attractions for months and years to come.